Hello, hello, welcome back to another YouTube video. And in this video, we are learning how to add page transition in latest Elementor Pro 3.6 version. They just released this feature and we'll be learning this in this video. So let's get into the screen. So guys, this is our Elementor site and we will apply page transition using Elementor Pro feature. So right now we don't have any page transition. If I switch on to subpages, as you can see, it doesn't come as an animated transition. It just comes as a blank. Now, what I'm gonna do, I'll go to site settings from here. Click on site settings. And from site settings, if you scroll down, you'll see page transitions. Click on page transitions. And now apply on entrance animation as fade in, and let's change the color as white and exit animation to be as fade out. We can adjust the animation speed as well. So let's make it 800. And after that, hit update. And now let's preview the changes. So now when I switch on to the pages now, if I click on from services to about us page, as you can see, we have this transition animation of fade in and fade out. Let's slow down. Let's make it a little faster because it looks like a white blank space. Now make it 400 ms and make the color to be gray and click on update again. And now let's go back to review how it looks now. Contact, as you can see, it's showing fade in and fade out. Let's try out a gradient color on page loading as a page transition. So click on gradient here. And then let's play with the colors. And let me take the current theme scheme, color scheme. So just take this blue color here. So I'm going to take the color from this background. And where's the color? Where's the color? Let's pick it up from here. So here we have the color code. I'm copying the color code and now let's apply it on our page transition gradient color. Here we go. And remove the pink and make it white color. White. Okay, now it's similar to what we have on our theme. Now let's play with the location thing. Radio. Nah, doesn't look good. Okay, much better. We can play with the angle as well. So that one looks good, right? Okay, now let's hit update and preview it. Now let's click on home page and there we go. Still shows the white color, so let me hard refresh to see if it fixes that issue. Okay, it works now. So transition in and fade in and fade out. Fade in and fade out. So that's how it's working. We can play with the different animation as well. So let's try and slide in from right and slide out left. Now let's preview that one. Click update. And now it should slide in from right and slide out from left. Okay, it's a little faster. when sliding out. So let's try again. Yeah, it's lagging a little bit, so make it a little slow. So increase the animation time by 800 ms, click update, and then preview the transition again. Okay, home, there we go, transition in and transition out. Transition in and transition out. Transition in and transition out. Perfect, looks good, right? Now let's try out the preloader feature which they have added. And here is the preloader. It's within the page transition settings. So when you go to site settings and click on page transitions, you will see the preloader just below the page transition. So let's try that out. Now let's remove the entrance animation here and apply the preloader. And in preloader, we can add animation. As you know, here's the animation, animated circle and circle dash. It actually looks pretty good, right? You don't have to play around with the JavaScript or anything. You can just do it by selecting from the drop-down menu of Elementor, which is pretty cool. I mean, it will take hours and hours if you build it through JavaScript. Overlap and spinners. Nice, that one looks good. We can also select colors. Okay, now let's try increasing the size and hit update to see how it looks on the front end. So go back to our website, and here we have our preloader. Our website is loading fast, so it's not taking much time, so that's how it will look. Let's remove our gradient which we added when adding page transition, so we don't need that anymore, and make the color clear. And now that's how it will look. Hit update. Okay, now switch the pages. And here we have our pages loading up with the preloader. And we have some other type of preloader, which is icon. We can add icon, any SVG icon. We can upload our custom SVG icon as well, and we can also animate them. So swing, nice, icon library, switch any different icon from it. Let's switch that one, insert. Okay, nice. Hit update and take a look how it looks. It doesn't show animation. So try a different animation, spinning. Okay, switch to this one here, click insert and hit update. Now let's see how this one looks. About, nice, that one looks good, right? We can also add custom images by selecting the image dropdown and select any of the images from our media library. So let's try this globe here. And that one also looks good, right? Click update and let's preview it. Okay, click on about, and that's how it works. Nice. So that's pretty much it for the video. I hope you guys liked it. Comment, like, and share. Bye bye.